Everybody, it's Evicta. It's time to continue eating streak here in the Binding of Isaac Evicta Afterbirth Plus series. Thank you, everybody, for the support here. The like streak counter is indeed back on point. With not only yesterday's video going over, but the day before's as well. Thank you all very much. That one actually got over 4,000 likes after everything had caught up. So, unbelievable job, Mosh Pit. Here's your meme of the day brought to you by Gonzo Link. And when Sissy looked upon her kingdom, she wept, for she had no mere words left to conquer, worlds to conquer, something like that. It's hard to read in black. Look, next time, if you're going to make a meme, if you're going to make a meme image, make sure you use white text with a black, like, outline. So it's a lot easier to read than just black on any color. Today's going to be JFK B Mets. My favorite, that's my favorite restaurant to eat at Dodger Stadium. Dodger Stadium? Yeah, sure, whatever. Sure, Dodger Stadium's Invicta. Well done. Well done. Anyway, we've got amazing damage here thanks to Synth Oil. Very, very good movement. Well, not good movement speed, but good HP. Kind of bad movement speed, actually, but shot speed is also a little lackluster. I am going to take Bobby Bombs only because we don't have anything to work with right now in terms of consumables. And this is also a very strange floor one. It's a very big floor one. And of course, we also have Mom's Bottle of Pills, which doesn't even matter because obviously we're just never going to use them unless we get PhD or Virgo because we don't take pills here. Very excited to see the reaction to Animal Crossing showing up on the channel. A lot of people seem to be really stoked about it. Lots and lots of people in the Mosh Pit had said that they'd never even seen Animal Crossing before, so it's very awesome. And I think I did a halfway decent job, I think, maybe a little bit better than that. Of introducing the game to newcomers. It's just that I'm not a veteran of the series at all. Like the Animal Crossing series is a very old series at this point. So there's obviously a lot of metagame stuff that that is involved with it, and a lot of secrets that the game just flat out doesn't tell you. Like, they don't tell you that you can bury a sack of bells and have it spawn a tree, a literal money tree that pays three times what you put in there. They don't tell you that, right? They don't tell you that there's also a limit to how much you can put in there. I mean, it's all trial and error. Actually, surprised it's not there. It could be here. If it's not there, then the only other spot it could be is in between the cursed room and, yeah, okay. Well, I'm glad that we wasted all those bombs for that. You get a nickel out of it. We did get a nickel out of it. And we've got one more bomb left. No soul heart, sad face, and a chest full of spiders. All right. But we do have enough to at least buy a soul heart in the store. Obviously, I'm not going to do that yet because we have to fight the boss first. But with 6.01 damage, this should be a piece of cake. Even if it is haunt, we should be okay. But yeah, the Animal Crossing video is over 6,000 views. I think almost 1,000 likes as well. So that's phenomenal for a brand new series. and again, with the way that the Animal Crossing game is, I don't know. That was a great dodge. Thank you. No, thank you. I don't know how many videos we're gonna get out of it, but I'm gonna try to keep it fun and festive and also like kind of focused because like you can get kind of distracted in that game very, very easily. And there's like always like something I want to do whenever I'm playing the game. So we get our second syringe, by the way, here with the Roid Rage. That's gonna greatly increase our movement speed. as much as I really want Blue Map, it's better for us to get a Soul Heart here. It's just better. Blue Map is good, but I mean, if you're adequate enough at finding secret rooms, which of course I usually am, then you shouldn't need the blue map. The only thing that the blue map gives you is just a general direction of where the boss room possibly is. All right, we immediately go into a dead end here. No problem at all. Not a problem. So thank you again, everyone, for the support on that one. What we're looking for here in this run, now that we've got our movement speed taken care of, definitely shot speed. Shot speed is our next big kind of get that we want. We don't have enough money to go into the store right now. 4 cents is really not enough to buy anything unless we get like a half price key or something. So it's much better for us to, under normal circumstances, if we had even more than 5 cents, I would definitely say go into the store first. Now that we have this blood bank though, it's tempting. Well, we get more movement speed here from Ares, and that's going to be it in terms of our movement speed. But with this Temperance card, though, with this Temperance card, we should be able to go back and get into the store and actually buy whatever we need. I'm kind of a little bit peeved that we got pushed into that shot from these Stonies.
Hey, Tyrone, what's a great idea for a new mom?
How about we make these giant stone fat Isaacs that the player can't destroy? They would just push them around. It'd be so cool. It's almost as cool as Ragman.
Sounds good. Go ahead and add it in.
You can technically destroy the stonies if you have Littlehorn. Not Littlehorn the boss, but Littlehorn the item. The one that shoots out the orange glowing black tear. That's about the only thing in the game that can destroy the stonies. Gotta be careful in here, obviously, with the super jump. On top of that, we also have little monstros to deal with. So, in other words, this is just one of the most dangerous rooms of the entire game. Especially when we're trying to sitting here holding on to a half of a soul heart, try to make the devil deal work. If we get out of this room unscathed, that's pretty good, yeah. All right, Necesito La Tienda, or Lo Tienda, De Tienda, I don't know, it's Tienda something. Fortunately, we cannot get that bomb there. We find the boss room of all things. Not what I was expecting here. Our movement speed, of course, is fantastic. 1.73 is a little bit faster than I prefer, but I'd much rather have the higher movement speed than the lower movement speed. And the only reason why I get a little picky when it comes to movement speed is because you do have to worry about if Isaac's moving too fast, you will slide around on the ground, and it makes you generally less accurate in your dodging, and that's not exactly what you want. We could risk it for a biscuit here and go for the. I mean, we have half of a soul heart. We should be fine. Speaking of Limehorn, we got ourselves a Limehorn. Non-champion Littlehorn inside of this arena should be a slam dunk for us. Slam dunk because you can just do this. So if you have too many of the dark matter balls that are chasing you, just simply run them into the fire. Unless, of course, Littlehorn puts like the most perfect troll bomb ever and stops your movement. But if your movement speed is as good as ours right now, you can just play circle strats here and just do this. And then if the fire isn't destroyed by the time that you're done with Littlehorn, then you can just yeet them into the fire like this. One, and then two. Easy as pie. And we get an HP upgrade. Hooray for that. And we get Dark Prince's Crown, which won't really do much, except we are able to at least activate it with the Temperance Machine here. The Blood Bank. So we have to go down to one red heart, nothing more, nothing less, in order for us to activate Dark Prince's Crown, which is going to give us a very nice all stats up. And that's a full clear of floor two, which I wasn't trying to do. We've done a square circle. Not WWE style, but just it's a square that's also like a circle. I mean, come on. that's not rocket science here. Ooh, man. We get Hive Mind. Hive Mind would be primo if we can afford it. And we can. They might be wondering, well, why would you take Hive Mind if you don't even have anything that activates flies right now? The answer is quite simply, Hive Mind is such a safe future-proofing. Did we not get the Dark Prince's Crown is active, but it's not. Our stats didn't change. Unless I'm missing something. Yeah. I don't know what's going on. I thought I saw our stats go up, but then they didn't.
Judgment.
I mean, regular judgment here, which obviously we're not going to play. And I really, really want to get the soul heart. Okay, so it was active. Oh, wow, we got a nickel out of that. Thinking I'm gonna be greedy here. We're not done yet. I'm gonna use it on this bomb here just because it's completely free. I know the secret room's here.
Don't talk to me.
Curse the maze, all right. I was incorrect with the Dark Prince's Crown. It actually doesn't give you a damage upgrade. It gives you a movement, not a movement speed, range upgrade, tears upgrade, and shot speed upgrade. Good to know. I also have Judas's Tongue, by the way. That's the name of our trinket, and it will cut the cost of the Devil Deals in half. Which is very nice if you're working off a Red Heart HP, which of course is what we're doing. But now we have to be extremely careful. I'm real glad that we came all the way over here for that. Especially with rooms like these, where not only we have a champion, Ipecac Gaper to worry about, but also, of course, we've got these freaking demon fires that will fire at us at any, pretty much any moment. All right, so that's going to get us back into the Dark Prince's Crown. Yeah, so shot speed, tears, and range, which is still good. It's still good. Don't get me wrong. Okay, just going to be another wrong way to go here. It's all right. All right, well, there's the eastern and southern side of this map. Okay, well, here's the western side, everyone. We made it. Congrats. Glad that we're all here to see this through. You're seeing how much of a big difference it is to have that increased shot speed. It gives us... We no longer look like we've got like a 10-tier delay. You know, now we actually look like we have a very high rate of fire. And that's just due to the fact that, obviously, our shots are reaching the target faster than they normally would. I mean, I guess I'll take the body. It's going to ruin Dark Prince's Crown at this point, but... For safety reasons, I'll take the body. But, you know, I'd really, really like it if we can get just a non-Red Heart... upgrade eventually. I mean, it gives us a lot of fodder for the Deal of the Devil, for sure. And our damage is still adequate for now, but again, went ahead, get more ahead, and that's exactly what I want to do. I want to get more damage here. Dude, fatty batty. No one... I don't care if your girlfriend's watching, dude. No one's impressed with your dodging skills. Perfect upgrade for us would be like a damage multiplier, Ease Mascara, ironically. Well, Ease Mascara would be still tough. A lot of people seem to really think that Ease Mascara is just always good. I'm here to tell you, it's not always good. There are situations that you do not want to have Ease Mascara. And when you've already got a low base shot speed, that would definitely be one of those cases, just because your shots can come to a screeching halt. If you don't have the range or if you don't have the shot speed, it can be very, very brutal. You have to get essentially like close range. Closer than you normally would. Like way past the safety zone. I'm trying to goad them into shooting us over here so we can get this chest, because we really, really need to get a bomb. Come on, dude. Help me out one time. Yeah. There we go. Thank you. Gonna be Gertie Jr. Hopefully she drops us something that's better than HP. 33% Deal with the Devil chance, of course. Not expecting to get one, because that's just how the odds go. If we get one, that'd be great, though, because I'd sure love to get rid of this Red Heart HP. It's kind of dangerous. Don't ever, ever, ever go vertical with Gertie Jr. You're making it a lot difficult on yourself, especially if you don't have movement speed. Luckily, we do have the movement speed. We get the Pentagram. That would be another fantastic upgrade for us, and we're gonna head on down. I've been told that we are on pace to hit 140,000 subscribers today, actually. And that is not an April Fool's. And I know that some people may have thought that, like, oh, the streak has ended today. No, I'm not. I've never been a fan of April Fool's, just because I think that they're just... Like, what's the best way I can describe this? For me, April Fool's is just a giant waste of effort out of a lot of people. You know, like, it's like everyone goes through these huge elaborate pranks, and I mean, let's be honest, we haven't seen like a really elaborate April Fool's prank in a while, which is good, because I think that it's just a smarter way for people to just use their time. Like, literally anything is better than dedicating any sort of like joke website or anything like that, you know. But at the same time, though, I've never been a fan of just pranks in general, because it's just like, you know, even like the ones that aren't like mean-spirited, like the hidden camera ones. I mean, those are okay. Those are pretty tame. But it's just, I don't know. There's something about them that I've just never enjoyed, because it's like, oh, you get a genuine reaction out of someone who thinks that they're invisible. Yeah. You know, and it's like, then that guy or that girl gets to spend the rest of their life being like, oh, you were that idiot who thought they were invisible. You know what I mean? Even if they sign off on it, obviously on those shows, like, you know, on the hidden camera shows, they have to have legal permission to televise that. And I'm sure that most people probably don't feel like that, but like, that's always going to be something that I'd be thinking about. Like, yeah, there goes that idiot that thought that they were actually invisible. You know, it's just, I don't know. Even though it's not mean-spirited, some of them can be mean-spirited. And just not my jam for entertainment. I think there's better ways to spend time than dedicating to April Fool's pranks. You know, we've all seen the Blizzard April Fools, and yes, it was very cool when they said that we were gonna have Uncle Deckard and Heroes of the Storm. Oh wait, that was real? What? But you know, it's like, yeah, it's just a bad. It's so bad just because you can never do anything meaningful on April 1st because everyone's gonna think it's just a joke. Hey guys, we hit 140,000 subscribers on my YouTube channel. Isn't that awesome? Ah ha ha, April Fool's Invicta. Very good. Go back to making Isaac videos. No, seriously, we hit 140,000 subs. Yeah, hi. Yeah, we heard you the first time. Very clever. All right, you can go now. You know, it's like, you just can't say anything meaningful. Red Candle is tempting here because we just don't have a space for item, but to be honest, at the first chance I get, I'm going to get rid of Red Candle for like a HP generator. I do want... It's in our best interest to actually get more options here. We're only on floor 4. Like, we're going to get 3 more... Unless we get the Bloody Crown, we're going to get at least 3 more item rooms, or 3 more bosses, I should say. That will give us an additional item from them. Even more options is the one that gives you extra items in your item room, which is not the one that we're looking at buying. We're looking at buying just more options, which is the extra boss room drop. Scorpio is fine by me. But the reason why I'm not taking Red Candle, even though I really want it, is just because there is a high chance that we're going to see a book that, like Book of Revelations or the Satanic Bible, that's going to give us a Black Soul Heart. And I would absolutely toss the... I would totally get rid of the Red Candle for that. You know, we're not in a dire situation damage-wise to really be hurting for Red Candle. Red Candle is fantastic, don't get me wrong. In almost every situation, Red Candle is going to be smart. But it's not really something that we need. We need a little bit more HP security than we do, like, you know, damage. Almost got me. Okay, Super Wrath. We should get some bombs out of this. Mr. Mega would be awesome. Even though I'm not a fan of Bobby Bombs, Mr. Mega Bobby Bombs are fantastic for taking out bosses. And I would not kick it out of bed. Or just get 3 bombs. That's fine, too. Thanks, Wrath. Hey, you tried, right? You're still my favorite. You're my favorite of the 7. I'm not talking about the anime either, by the way. Although I have been watching the anime. I'm on episode 20. I just finished episode 23 right now. I was surprised. I thought that the game was going through like all of the seasons of the story, but apparently not, because I think I'm close to the end of season 1 in 7 Deadly Sins, and what they're like, where they're at right now was at like the very, very end of the game for the gacha game. So I was surprised that it took that long for me to get through season 1 in the game. I thought that it was covering the entire like series up to like, you know, I think there's two or three seasons out right now, but it's been enjoyable. It definitely has a lot of similarities from other shonen anime out there, you know, just lots and lots of anime tropes, but they're tropes because they're common because they work, you know, they get you invested. There's always the hero who has a dark side and blah, 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 but it's entertainment, and I'm certainly enjoying it more than Demon Slayer, I can tell you that. I was really liking Demon Slayer until it's Zenitsu, but we've already been over that. Although, I will say, I think I've already mentioned this once before. The Mosh Pit on Twitch was telling me that I can actually get through Demon Slayer by fast-forwarding. There's our spun, by the way. By fast-forwarding through the parts with Zenitsu in it and not miss a beat. So that has me a little bit more encouraged that I can finish the series. And we're going to take Guppy's tail here because we just got the Book of Sin, and that should offset a lot of the key drought. So that has me a little bit more hopeful that I can get through the rest of the first season of Demon Slayer to just to see it, because it was a decent anime, but man, Zenitsu just killed it for me. I mean, like, even in Seven Deadly Sins, like Hawk, I didn't like Hawk when I first played the game, the mobile game, and then when I started up the anime, I was like, oh man, I'm just gonna hate this character. But the thing about Hawk is that, like, he's not like always around, like, and he's definitely not always screaming, you know, and he's definitely not around screaming and whining at the same time, like Zenitsu is. And I just that's the part that kills me about that, man, is just that the constant screaming is just, it's so obnoxious and over the top. I know that he's a polarizing figure, and I know that he's very popular in Japan, and There's a certain amount of Western audience that also enjoy him, but man, I couldn't. He's just awful. Just awful. But I was very happy to hear that you can get by without having to ever hear him again. So I am A-okay with that. That's the kind of thing I like to hear. 3 bombs to get 4 keys is a pretty good deal, again, considering the fact that we have the Book of Sin, which is going to drop us a random consumable here. Very, very good to have. Of course, we also got Spun, which is going to be a huge, huge up for us. Now, obviously, I have to be worried about our movement speed a little bit because it is too fast. I mean, it doesn't get any faster than this, to be honest. But, you know, we do have to be careful of the whole sliding thing. The Book of Sin can drop Soul Hearts and Black Soul Hearts. Always feels like Christmas when it happens. Doesn't happen too often, but when it does, it's, like Christmas. Guppy's Tail is going to increase the frequency of us getting chests that drop at the end of a stage. However, it's at usually the cost of keys because they take place over... They override any key spawns with chests. So unless if you have unlimited keys or a way to open up chests without expending keys, then you're going to be in a little bit of trouble. And Guppy's Tail is, in my opinion, by far the worst Guppy item. Some people are going to say that that's Guppy's Hairball. I wholeheartedly disagree with that. Guppy's Hairball can do a fantastic amount of damage, and you can use it for defense as well if you have enough movement speed and if you are good at controlling Isaac enough. But Guppy's Tail is definitely the most detrimental out of the Guppy items. Okay, well, we're just going to keep on searching here, I guess. If you would have told me that the item room was to the south, I would have believed you, but now I'm not so sure. Not going to take the egg just because it is quite awful. And you might be saying, well, what's wrong with that? Well, the problem is that it spawns enemies that will actively try to shoot at Isaac. And it's the same thing along the lines with Abel. You'll see a shot that's coming towards you, and you will inadvertently try to dodge out of that just based on instinct and reflexes, only to find out that, no, that was a friendly shot, and you actually have just walked into an unfriendly shot. And that makes it quite awful, because I don't know why the enemies are programmed to do that, but man, is it annoying. I'm not going to use the Hermit card here, because we already have unlimited keys, and it's going to be a greed fight, of course. Yeah, and that's the whole momentum thing I was just talking about, where you can't put on the brakes fast enough to turn around and change direction before a shot hits you right in the face. I was about to say, I have a feeling he's going to be Gish. I was trying not to jinx it, but I should have said it because it would make me look a little bit smarter. Much like Monstro, if you have enough movement speed, you can indeed. You can sneak underneath Gish, underneath the small little jumps that they do, the little hops. That hop right there. if you have the movement speed. Is it safe to do that? No. But if you want to impress your friends, then go for it. There's the maze, hooray. Little Gish is okay. I mean, I just don't take him just because it's just another one of those followers, man. It's the same thing. It's the same thinking along the lines of the reason why I don't take little Steven. Comparatively speaking to, like, say, Demon Baby, for example, Gish and little Steven are completely fine. If you compare them to Demon Baby, Demon Baby is actually, in my opinion, is a pretty dangerous follower to have, just because you can't control when he fires, and he has a very high tendency to shoot bombs back at Isaac after you place them. That's a big problem. Gish, little Steven, you can control when they're firing, so that's already a leg up. Very happy to see Small Rock slows us down, gives us a little bit more damage and more tears. Actually didn't slow us down at all, but that's all right. So with little Steven and little Gish, you can at least stop them from firing. You know, yes, it's annoying, especially if you have them, if they're appearing in the third follower spot, like where Lil Gish was going to be. Lil Gish would not be next to us. He would be behind the mystery sack. And that just makes him even more unwieldy. No, absolutely not for Tech 2. No. No, 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 no. All right, we want this to at least take us down to 1 HP so we can get the benefit of the crown. There we go. Thank you very much. We'll go ahead and drop a bomb here on Monty, just to teach him a lesson that we don't remember we gave him. Okay. If we need more money, we can always go back and get more, as long as the blood bank is still there, of course. Seagram's there guaranteed. Seagram's there guaranteed. Okay, well, at least we know that our store is going to be fine. When you're fighting Super Greed, don't try to dodge. Just stand still. Hold your ground. Oh, we even get a quarter here, so that is going to take us to max money. I'm not going to pick it up right now because it's actually a waste of a decent amount of money there. I'm not going to use the Hermit card either. The main reason why I'm not going to do that is because I want to save it at this point, unless we get an Emperor card in the shop. I'm going to save it for the chest because the Hermit cards can take you to one of any random room in the chest. Basically any floor that doesn't have a store, it will take you to a random room. You can also use it to sneak at something out of there without actually having to do the room. But with 10.84 damage, like, you know, we can do anything. I mean, I'm not going to do boss rush, of course, because we've already missed it, but I'm also not going to do hush. Unless something really dramatic happens, where old Hushy is gonna be—he's gonna be safe. The old Hushy streak might be over here. People have been giving their feedback on the whole on Minecraft as well. Just because I'm doing Animal Crossing right now doesn't mean that we're not going to do Minecraft. I still want to do Minecraft. A lot of legitimate points were made. Some people were like, yeah, Minecraft is so old, though. It's been played out on YouTube, which I totally get. I 100% agree with you. But it's still an experience that I think that I would be able to at least have a little bit of fun with. Some other people have said that they don't recommend me playing hardcore just because they know me best. And they said that, yeah, it's not really a good idea with your temperament. And if you don't know what I'm talking about, I don't like playing hardcore in games just because, like, you know, you're going to screw up. Like, I'm not a very good gamer, you know. And I'm a little bit biased against hardcore modes in general. Hardcore, by the way, I'm talking about like a permadeath system. And that stems from an incident in Diablo 2 a long, long time ago, where I had a level 84 ice sorceress who was 84, 74, it was one of those two. I think she was 84. And I lagged out, my internet connection lagged out, and I ended up dying, and I was not happy about it. and very embarrassed too, because I ended up completely destroying my desk. This is back in my more ragier days, and I did all that while my friends who I were playing with, they were listening to all this on Ventrilo back in the day, for those of you who remember that program. So that was pretty embarrassing, and I ended up having to buy a new desk and I think a new keyboard as well. And after that, I swore off playing hardcore. I was like, never again, because I do not ever want to let, not mean to buy that, I don't want to let a computer game, like, kill a character that I've been working on for so long, only just to say, like, you know,
screw you,
you know, that sort of thing. I'm going to go back and get the quarter. Okay. I'm going to go back and get the quarter and pick up any red hearts along the way so we can play this Demon Judgment. Although, what we really should do is I should go fight the boss, get the Polaroid, and then use the Stars card that we got so we can just do the Demon Judgment with the Polaroid. That's just a lot easier. I can only remember where that Stars card was. So, for those of you who didn't know, every time Curse of the Maze procs, it shuffles around the entire floor, literally. So, some things that were in one room are no longer there. The second that you shuffle, everything gets moved. And that's why I get a lot of questions saying, like, wait a second, I saw him move out of that room, and all of a sudden he went back in that room. What's going on here? What kind of shenaniganery is this? What kind of modded save file are you using, Syndicta? Like, no, it's Curse of the Maze. That's what Curse of the Maze does. Notice how everything on the minimap's changing? You notice how that pill was there that wasn't there? Or this red heart there? Yeah. You know what? I don't even freaking care. Just give me... Just send me. Send me home. I'm gonna go back, get my hermit card, and then we're just gonna leave. Screw everything about this Curse of the Maze. Oh, it was already here. Well, screw everything anyway. My judgment, you can do us a solid here. Give me the compass, treasure map, basically anything other than just a red heart HP upgrade. You can't go wrong here. Anything other than an HP upgrade. Okay, but you got to pay out with something though. That's the kicker. You got to give me something. Yeah, but, like, you gotta, like, pay out with an item pedestal, though, because I've given you, like, half of a dollar. Okay. I will take Luckfoot, and we get a second upgrade as well. Honestly, that's actually huge. Thank you very much, Judgment. For once in your very temporary life, you did the right thing. Now, I'm gonna go back, and we're gonna go fight Mom and get the Polaroid, and then after that, we're going to go into the deal with the devil, assuming there is one, which, I mean, 78% of course is going to be. We can't miss that. Then we're going to teleport out with the Stars card and then go back, get our Hermit card, play the Demon Judgment, and hopefully get, like, a very good devil deal item so we can finally end this run. Apparently that does the Midas Touch effect. I never knew that. If I did, I've forgotten about it. Yeah, there's no HP on that bar, though, game. This is not how 0% HP works. Ceremonial robes, and let's go back to the store and play that Demon Judgment. And then we can finally get out of here. But Synvicta robes, of course, are awesome. Big damage upgrade for us. Gave us a little bit more of HP as well. So there's the Polaroid Invincibility proc, which we didn't even need because it gave us that. And we're just going to head on down because LOLOL. You know what? Let's just do it. Let's see what we can get out of here. Cricket's head, Steven, would be awesome. Of course, we can also just get nothing. That's fine, too. I am going to pick up this half heart. Even though that ruins Polar Invincibility for us, it does raise our DPS by a whole lot. Actually, I'm just gonna use that. Just send me. Just send me. The Hermit card can take you like closer to Blue Baby, but it can also take in the complete opposite direction. I mean, it's completely random. I'm ready to be done with Curse the Maze. Let's have no more Curse the Mazes on this run. How about that game? Yeah. Ludovico's not great here. Ludovico's not great in general. There's a double Tinder Rock. I thought it was a single Tinder Rock. Apologies. Didn't realize it was going to be that kind of party. I would have dressed up. I don't know what that means, but we're just going to roll with it. Well, at least the key economy is still holding strong for us. I'm very happy I have this High Priestess card when we inevitably fight the Matriarch, because that's what the game just gives us these days. Because I'm pretty sure that somebody is like hot swapping or patching the game every single time that I play. I'm important enough to where the developers just know, like, oh my gosh, Invicta's about to run. All right, get ready. Load up the Matriarch and make sure he doesn't get double deals. I'm that important. I've got a YouTube channel, sweetheart. Look it up. I mean, you're already here, so you don't have to look it up. In fact, you probably shouldn't look it up because it's going to take you away from here. Just stay right where you are. Don't do anything. Just stay right where you are. 2020 would be awesome here if we can get it from the library. And we can. But now the question becomes, do we stick with the Book of Revelations or do we go with the Book of Sin? I'm going to stick with the Book of Revelations here. We've gotten enough out of the Book of Sin, and we don't really need keys anymore. Plus, on top of that, we can also guarantee an orbital here, so we don't have to worry about fighting Matriarch now. Because that is what the Book of Revelations does. We'll spawn one of the horsemen, one of the harbingers. And I always thought they were harbingers. I don't know why. Yeah, it's stuck on the corner there while I was trying to dodge that shot. Pretty happy about that. Okay, all right. Let's look at the screen and let's make sure that we know how to play this game. Or let's just keep taking damage. It's fine too. Hey, Charge Baby, you remember that time when you used to drop, like, you know, full charges? Boy, those were the days, weren't it? Secret room should be north of here. Those phase doubles are keys. Very nice to have, especially considering that we have the tarot cloth. We're going to get Conquest. Now, is Conquest better than the Book of Revelations here? That is a good question. Technically, we weren't guaranteed an orbital here just because of the fact that Conquest exists. But honestly, I'm fine with Conquest. It's just, it comes down to, this is what happens. If we get a Devil Deal here, which we didn't, we have to decide whether or not we want flying and movement speed versus HP. We already have movement speed. Flying would be nice, but I'd rather just, let's keep it safe. Better safe than sorry. This gives us a little bit of a factor of leniency in terms of bad damage, which, as you've been seeing, we've been taking a whole lot of. Go ahead and change our face just because, good God, Isaac. Yeah, that's fine. People have been noticing that I've been coughing a lot less, which is good, because I have been. but yeah, the coughing is, I mean, it's just I'm getting over it. Usually the limitations on me having, like, having the gunk, the allergy stuff, is normally 2 to 3 weeks is when I get over it. And we're on the tail end of, like, 2.5 weeks right now. So, you know, I'm happy to not have to worry about it anymore. Not that I wasn't worried that it was you-know-what, but what I, you know, I just... I don't want people worrying about me. I don't like people worrying about me. It makes me feel good that people do, but it's completely unnecessary. I'll let you know if there's something to worry about. Let's put it that way. But more importantly, of course, it was disrupting the flow of commentary and whatnot. We get Juice's freaking shadow. I'm actually going to drop Juice's tongue here because I want to be charged more HP for this. And this, even though I don't like Headless Baby, this would guarantee us, at least for now, we lose our polar invincibility, but we'll gain that if we turn into Black Judas. But more importantly, we're now down to permanent Dark Prince's crown. So we have an extra life here. I'm not really interested in turning into Black Judas if we don't have to, even though, of course, Black Judas, he's my favorite character. And, you know, he's got an insane amount of stats, including damage. It's not necessary. I'd rather just have the HP at this point. Cause I mean, we're already doing ridiculous amounts of damage. You know, 12 damage is good enough to beat any boss in the game. Now we do have to factor into the fact that we don't have Polaroid invincibility. So, and this further reaffirms my decision to go with the Book of Revelations than stick with the Book of Sin, because of the fact that if we do have to turn into Black Judas, we'll be able to give ourselves more HP if we need it. This is a dice stream. I just want to see what it is. The Global D Twanky. Tammy said is good, not good enough. I do want the bomb so we can kind of blast our way through to Isaac. Emperor card, Hero Font card is actually fantastic. So now we have this option with this Hero Font card, because it's going to drop us 4 soul hearts. We have an option now of turning into Black Judas before we fight Isaac. And with the Book of Revelations here charged up, that's going to be 5 soul hearts. If we get one more full charge, then I'll turn into Black Judas now. One more full charge or a Hero Font card is it. Full card. Let's see what else there is over here. Well, that's right. We have the battery. So we are going to get a full charge. So yeah. So I think that now is a good time to turn into Black Judas. I like having the damage upgrade for us, and obviously the character's he's just the best. Plus, we go back down to polar invincibility. This makes total sense from a strategy standpoint, just because of the fact that we're going to get stronger here. Even though we lose Dark Prince's crown, we still gain the benefits. I mean, who cares about Dark Prince's crown when you can be freaking Black Judas, you know? So goodbye, Eden. Hello, Judas. Then we're going to hit the Book of Revelations to start us off here. 21 damage. The Hierophant. Yeah. That is a very good amount of HP that we just picked up. And this is right here is the reason why I hate taking Headless Baby. Is because obviously you see the creep that it leaves behind. It is literally indiscernible from enemy creep, and that has been a persistent problem in Isaac since Rebirth came out. There's no way to distinguish what's yours and what isn't yours. So, yeah, let's just fight him. Scorpio is going to do some pretty big work here. Thank you, Battery Baby. Charge Baby, whatever your name is. I've always called him Charge Baby. That's the worst case scenario for this fight. Not that we're in trouble or anything, but you never ever want to have one of the angel fetuses alive while you're fighting Isaac when he goes into phase 3. Because not only do you have to dodge Crack the Sky, which isn't admittedly that hard to do, but then you also have to worry about random shots coming in from the side and possibly flanking you. And it can eat away at your HP pretty quickly. But we've got nothing to worry about. Black Judas, we've got the Book of Revelation. That's a big old GG. And I appreciate it. It's been a little bit since we had Judas the Shadow. And, you know, he's my favorite character in the game. Oh, man, Mysterious Liquid is going to absolutely shred any boss that we come up against here. So Mysterious Liquid is going to leave that ooze on the ground, and it will do essentially dot damage or damage over time based on our base damage. So we essentially have a huge amount of just damage over time on any target that we blast with our regular shots here. And it leaves a little persistent pool behind, which is very, very nice, especially if you're dealing with stuff like Super Sloth, for example, that has spiders that spawn. It's very good at taking out those adds without really too much issue. Oh, man, double full charge. Absolutely. Gonna be a dead end. Gluttony just yeeted greed there. Undefined is tempting because that would take us to a secret room, but I'm not in a hurry to end the run. This run will end soon, and it'll be all over. I can go back to mining in Elite Dangerous and getting ready for tomorrow's affairs. Getting everything in order for the stream. By tomorrow, I mean today for you all. Tomorrow for me. But if you really are interested in seeing the Animal Crossing series become a day-to-day thing, now is the time to support it. Now is the time to let me know. Leaving a comment and all that kind of good stuff is great. Of course, the likes are even more important, and the feedback surveys that you see at the end of videos, all that stuff adds up to support any series that you see on here. Tech 1 is tempting, but I'm not going to take it. The temptation of Tech 1. The slowing effect that you see there was from Large Zit that we just got a couple rooms ago. We get PH Dizzle. A little bit too late, too little too late, PH Dizzle, but I'm glad you showed up anyway. Always a pleasure. In my opinion, you should always kill Sloth at the end because he has the chance to pay out with a tarot card. If you kill Gluttony if he's the last mob inside of that room, or really any rooms, and then you kill him and he drops an item, it's usually always going to either be less than three, or a lard. But if you kill Sloth last, then you're always guaranteed to get a chance to get a tarot card. You're not guaranteed a tarot card, but a chance. And then of course Wrath is going to be a bomb upgrade or just a bunch of bombs. Lust gives you basically nothing. I mean, he could drop the virus, I guess, but usually doesn't. That's fine. Hey, speak of the devil. Man, our movement speed's so fast, even taking the virus didn't slow us down at all. Small Rock and the virus didn't drop our movement speed one bit. That's how fast we're moving now, thanks to Spun. Unless Spun has a fixed movement speed of 2.0, which I don't think it does, but I guess I've never really thought about that. Bad on Mushroom. We could take it without really worrying, because obviously it gives us an empty heart container. We still maintain our Polaroid invincibility while also getting the damage up benefit of Fat on Mushroom. And we're just chilling like a villain here in the chest, looking for that blue baby room. I wouldn't mind getting another tiers upgrade just to really send our DPS over the edge. Take it to another level, you know. Gotta really want it, bro. I don't know what this Chad voice is, but. That's actually what I sounded like back when I was working out all the time. Working out just makes you do a Chad, man. So thank you for watching, everyone. Very good run. A little bit of a long-winded run, admittedly, but You know, we didn't get really too many big time powerhouse items until, you know, the second half of the run. And of course turning into a blue Judas, yeah, sure. Blue Judas is really, really good. Dark Prince's Crown definitely gets a little bit of a nod here, but I'd say the MVP has to go to the Book of Sin. Alright, you know what? No, MVP goes to Synth Oil. MVP goes to Synth Oil because we started and ended with it, and it put us on a very good pace here. So thank you for watching, everyone. If you enjoyed this video, click the like button. If you didn't, click the dislike button. Either way, it supports my channel. If you do see a post-video survey, kindly consider filling out that for 5 stars. It does go a very long way supporting myself here and other content creators who you may watch on YouTube. And I hope you had a great start to your day. And as always, I'll see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody.